Hello friends, welcome back once again. Today in this video lecture we are going to discuss the mechanism of the anti-ulcer drug. So to understand the mechanism of the anti-ulcer drug and the various classes of the anti-ulcer drug, firstly we have to understand that what are the different receptor or what are the different pathway by which the acetyl HCl secretions increases from the parietal cells in the GIT regions. So here I have summarized a basic diagram of the secretions of the HCl, that is hydrochloric acid, into the parietal cells. So here this is the diagram of the parietal cells, and in the parietal cells HCl acid secretions increases by the different pathway mechanism is here. So here is the channel which is responsible, that is the hydrogen potassium ATPase pump. Simply we called it the proton pump. So here is the proton pump. This proton pump have the property to increase the hydrogen ion concentration into the gastric gland lumen and absorption of the potassium ion into the parietal cells. So here hydrogen ion increases into the gastric gland lumen. How? Basically this proton pump is regulated by the various different mechanisms. Also here is the first, that is the gastrin have their receptor into the parietal cells, that is known as the CCK2 receptor, that is the cholecystokinin receptor. This cholecystokinin receptor acted through the calcium dependent pathway, and by this calcium dependent pathway it stimulate the proton pump and increases the hydrogen ion concentration. Another one here is the acetylcholine that have the muscarinic receptor. Here is the muscarinic receptor, and basically the muscarinic receptor, this muscarinic receptor have the property that also regulated through the calcium dependent pathway and activated the proton pump. Third one here is the histamine receptor, histamine H2 receptor. This histamine H2 receptor have the agonist, that is the histamine. When the histamine bind on this receptor, then by the CMP dependent pathway, and it increases the CMP. So CMP dependent pathway, it activated the proton pump and also help into the secretions of the hydrochloric acid. So these three and this proton pump are the major controlling or regulating channel during the secretions of the hydrochloric acids. There is another one, that is the EP3 receptor. This EP3 receptor is for the prostaglandin. Here your prostaglandin will be binded, and through this EP3 have the property to decrease the secretions of the HCl. So it inhibited the proton pump and decreases the hydrochloric acid secretions. Very easy. So these are the different site at which our anti-ulcer drug mainly act. On the basis of this, we have summarized all the classes of the anti-ulcer drugs. Here is the first class, proton pump inhibitor. As we have discussed that this proton pump is the major controlling pathway during the secretions of the acid into the gastric gland lumen. So proton pump inhibitor have the examples omeprazole, lansoprazole, rabeprazole, esomeprazole. These are the all the azole, here all the prazole drug are under the proton pump inhibitor, and these have the property to inhibit the hydrogen potassium ATPase pump. Simply proton pump, it inhibit the proton pump. Second one, we have discussed the H2 receptor. This H2 receptor, that is the H2 antihistaminics are the example, have the cimetidine, ranitidine and famotidine, all the tidine class drug under the H2 antihistaminic, and these have the property to inhibit the H2 receptor. If they inhibit the H2 receptor, then this CMP dependent pathway will decrease also, that will inhibit this proton pump and decreases the HCl secretion. Third one, anticholinergic. This anticholinergic drug inhibit this muscarinic receptor, and here the mainly muscarinic receptor which is present, that is the M1 muscarinic receptor. So M1 antagonist is there, pyrenzepine and telenzepine, M1 receptor antagonist. These have the property to block the M1 receptor. Next, prostaglandin analog. As we have discussed, these muscarinic receptor, H2 receptor and the proton pump, these help into the secretions of acid, while this prostaglandin EP3 receptor inhibit the HCl secretions. So here in this case, we should give the analog, means agonist. Like the example, misoprostol. Misoprostol is the prostaglandin analog that inhibit the proton pump and other actions also. So here is the misoprostol have the action, protective action, and promote mucus and bicarbonate secretions, because mucus and bicarbonate increases the protection of the GIT. So here it helps into the protective actions. Next, antacid. These all four are inhibit the HCl secretions, while this antacids have the property to neutralize the already secreted HCl secretions. Okay, so here we have the antacid, that is the sodium bicarbonate, calcium carbonate, magnesium hydroxide, aluminium hydroxide and megaldrate. These all have the property to neutralize the already secreted gastric acid. So neutralize gastric acid. Next one, ulcer protective. As its name indicate, this is the protective. So these drug have the protective action on your mucus region of the gastric region. So example, we have the sucralfate. Sucralfate have the property to polymerize at the pH less than 4. pH less than 4, these sucralfate polymerizes and adhere on the surface of the GIT, and that helps into the protective action of the GIT. Next, ulcer healing. As its name indicate, it heal the region where already the wound occurs. So here we have the example, that is the carbenoxolone. Carbenoxolone is a natural compound obtained from the Glycyrrhiza glabra. Okay, and this have the property to increase the mucus production. If the mucus amount, your mucus concentration increases at the gastric region, that help into the healing of that wound region. So this have property to increase the mucus production. Now the anti-H. pylori drug, as these have the action which is directly through the acid, while this H. pylori have also property to induce the ulcer. So here anti-H. pylori drugs are also given to kill or inhibit the growth of the H. pylori. Here we have example, amoxicillin under the penicillin class drug, metronidazole, tinidazole, tetracycline, chloramphenicol also given, and these all have the property to kill or inhibit the growth of the bacteria. So killing of the bacteria, these have the from mechanism of action. So these are the example of the anti-ulcer drug and their mechanism. Just simply I will clear one point. Peptic ulcer is the reason when the concentration of HCl increases and that damage the mucus region of the gastric mucosa. Why? When on the basis of location, this peptic ulcer can be two types, gastric ulcer, while second one esophageal gastric ulcer and esophageal ulcer. Gastric ulcer is that when the ulcer occurs during the gastric region, while esophageal reflux also that is the action, and that occurs in the esophageal region. Next one is the intestinal ulcer. When this ulcer reaches to the intestinal region, that will called as the intestinal ulcer. So on the basis of location, it can be vary, but overall we called is the peptic ulcer. So here is the summary of the peptic ulcer, their different anti-ulcer drug and the mechanism of those drug. Thank you.